Brian McTaggart has covered the Astros as a beat writer for the better part of 15-plus years. He's with MLB.com and joins us from Minute Maid Park. So, Brian, thanks for the visit today. Let's talk about James Click and some of the challenges he faces early on in his GM tenure. Look, that culture is pretty complicated, and it would be a tough chair to assume with zero previous experience. Click does bring some significant baseball intel to the job, however.
Yeah, he's definitely got a lot on his plate coming into this situation. You remember when the report was released a few weeks ago by Major League Baseball, the word used, the culture in the Astros front office, and was problematic. Now, that was something the owner, Jim Crane, disagreed with, but clearly, Manfred went ahead and made a decision to suspend Luno and suspend the manager, and Crane came out and ended up dismissing both. So he comes in facing that challenge as well. What's the culture? How is he going to approach that and clean things up? He's also got a roster now that has a payroll of about $220 million with nowhere really to go. You have some extensions that need to be addressed, perhaps with guys like George Springer. And then in the next couple of years, you have Verlander and Greinke and Carlos Correa facing free agency. How do you navigate all that? And then you also have a farm system that only has one prospect on the top 100 in MLB pipeline. You remember for years, the Astros had 5, 6, 7 prospects. Some of those have graduated to the big leagues like Alvarez and Kyle Tucker, Alex Bregman. Well, now they're down to one because they've traded away a lot of prospects the last few years. So he's facing that as well. And he doesn't have his first and second round draft picks the next 2 years. So a lot on his plate. But, you know, he does inherit a team that is built to win this year. He does, I mentioned the $220 million payroll. That's probably three times what the Rays were operating with last year. So that is a luxury to have for this year. So I think he's got a little bit of a honeymoon period here to try to find out which direction this ball club is going to go, how he's going to get it to set course beyond 2020. Because I think in 2020, we know this is a team built to win. They're going to have to deal with a lot of stuff off the field. There's going to be a lot of distractions. But certainly Click's got time, I think, to come in and spring training and in the season and sort of just digest everything, maybe surround himself with some people that have been here before, that know the decisions that need to be made, and lean on them a little bit, and then see what course this franchise goes.
So I'm curious your thoughts. It went through a number of candidates as they've gone through this process trying to figure it out. It was awful slick. They ended up with James Click. How'd they do it?
Yeah, well, he interviewed last week. I was really surprised they did this so quickly. If you remember last week when they introduced Dusty Baker as the manager, it seemed like the GM was really on the back burner at that point. And Jim Crane seemed to indicate it could be into spring training, could be mid-March before they get a GM in place. Now, remember, they've always thought that getting a manager first because they were so close to spring training. But, you know, in the 3 weeks since Hinch and Luno got fired, they've done pretty well considering the pool of candidates they have, the tight time frame they had to work on. They get Dusty Baker, one of their most respected men in the game, a manager with a great track record. And now they get a guy in James Click from a front office that has been, one of the best in baseball the last few years. Worked under Heim Bloom for a long time. Heim Bloom goes to the Red Sox. Click gets more responsibilities. Now Astros are able to go in there and get someone from that Rays front office that's very analytically driven. And he's going to be able to come over to Houston to a similar type front office that is analytically driven as well, with a bigger payroll. And so I think the Astros did pretty well, I think, in the three-week span they had getting Dusty Baker and James Click.
Yeah, they clicked him off that tree, that's for sure.
And it just doesn't stop. I'm sorry, Brian. Sorry for all this. We'll do some of this shtick in a minute. But I want to ask you this, because it sounded like Jim Crane had made a lot of baseball decisions himself prior to the hiring of James Click. We know that to be the case. Does James Click have any license now as far as his own staff? Like, is he going to be able to bring other people with him? I would imagine that the Rays, who have had their cupboard kind of torn apart here this offseason, would be very reluctant to allowing James Click to bring someone else with him from Tampa.
Yeah, and it might be tough right now, so close to spring training. I mean, you're going to have to get permission from the Rays or any other team. They're going to try to, get someone from another team. So, I don't know if that's going to be the case. You know, they do have some really capable people here in the Astros front office. Jeff Luno's gone. Brandon Taubman is gone. They were the top two guys at the end of last year in the regular season. But guys like Pete Putilla, still very much here. Kevin Goldstein, who, like James Click, did some work for Baseball Prospectus before he got into the front office, is here as well. And before Luno was fired, he promoted several guys through the ranks, getting promotions up in a couple of different waves of promotions, Pete Putillo, one of them. So he's got some very, very capable people in this front office. And I think at some point, certainly, I think we'll see some additions from the outside. I don't know if he can do that now before spring training starts. I'd just be hard to imagine, you know, being able to get permission from other clubs to do something like that. But I think he'll shape his own staff and lean on a lot of the people here and probably at some point bring in some people as well.
Astros doing their best to move forward. Brian McTaggart of MLB.com joining us with the latest from Minute Maid Park. Brian, we appreciate the time.
Thank you.